Hello everyone, my name is Berthe and welcome back to my channel. Today, in this video, we are exploring the Snowy Escape Create-A-Sim items. I am doing that by creating my maybe future Let's Play family. I made these Sims on stream on Twitch, so if you are interested in seeing me play The Sims and other games live, you can follow me on Twitch. Link is in the description. The first sim you're seeing here may be familiar to you. She is a sim I made for the Zodiac Signs as Sims series on my channel. So if you want to watch that, go check it out in the description. But yeah, so she has already got a lot of outfits, but I'm just adding some Snowy Escape outfits to them. And to be fair, I really do like the stuff that comes with Snowy Escape. When it comes to Create-A-Sim, I haven't played yet, I must admit. And as I said, this may be a family I will be playing on the channel. You guys gotta let me know in the comments whether you are or are not very interested in a Snowy Escape Let's Play, because I feel like the whole YouTube, Sims YouTube, is now flooded by Snowy Escape Let's Plays. And I am very interested to know if that is something you actually want to see, or are you like, nah, I've seen a million, thank you, I'll watch something else now. So yeah, that's what I'd like to know from you guys in the comments. Just to pitch the story of my Let's Play, this is the mom. Her name now is a Chinese name. I don't remember how to pronounce, but I will change the name anyways to something I can pronounce. So, the story, let me get my notes. This is the mom of the family. She is a traditional woman. I'm gonna give her the proper trait as well. She's neat and a music lover because she likes to play the piano. She is into yoga and meditation, and she is definitely a workaholic. She's in the salesperson career, and she works long, long hours, and yoga and meditation is a way for her to decompress, and playing piano as well. But as I said, very traditional and very hardworking. Now, this guy is her brother. So, he is more of a chill guy. He loves skiing, he's always there for his family, and he lives nearby, so he's very close to the mother and her kids that I'm going to be making after this sim. So he's very close to them and has a very good bond with the children, definitely with the little boy that I'm going to be telling about later. And yeah, as I said, he's more of a chill guy, he's adventurous, he is outgoing, just a chill guy. Then the next sim, I am not making her yet, but the next sim is going to be the daughter. She's a teen, and she has a bad relationship with her mother. Why? Well, because her mom is never home, because she's always working. Plus, she doesn't support her career choice, because this girl wants to be a famous snowboarder. And her mom wants her to go to college and go into a more serious career, so to say. Here she is. I don't know a name for her yet. I think I might call her Blossom, because that's cute. She has a lot of tattoos, which her mom doesn't approve of. She's gonna have piercings. Basically, there's this dynamic, like, her mother doesn't agree with something, she's gonna do it. Her mom doesn't like something, she's gonna do it. She's very provocative and rebellious, and she does everything to piss her mom off, basically. For her style, I thought it would be cool, like her everyday style, to combine Snowy Escape sport wear with normal kind of tops. So she has this colorful sport pants with simple black shirts on it, and I really like that. And what I try to go for is colorful and different. Not like specifically very alternative or something, but just different. And I definitely love her outfit. She is my favorite sim. Should I be doing this Let's Play, then I have also added some possible love interests for her in the save file that I'm playing in. They are kind of like tough people, very alternative, and her mom doesn't like that if she would end up with one of those, but she may. And there's also another young adult woman I've added in the save that is probably going to be the friend of the mom. I hate how I call them the mom and the daughter, but they don't have names yet. Oh, name suggestions. Feel free to leave some name suggestions in the comments. Yes, they can be Japanese or otherwise Asian-inspired names, but do let me know how to pronounce them then, because I want names that I know how to pronounce. And to be fair, I don't know anything about Japanese or Chinese language. So, that's why they don't have names yet, because I want to give them traditional kind of names, but I don't know which names and how to pronounce them. But we'll get there, we'll get there. Leave me any name suggestions in the comments. Also, just American names, English names are fine. Then there's also the son. He's a child, but he's probably gonna age up into a teen quite soon, because I want to use the children to kind of explore the aspirations that come in this game. I forgot to say that the daughter is gonna be adventurous and hot-headed, and her aspirations is going to be the new adventurous Mount Komorebi sports aspiration. I don't remember the name, I'm sorry. Anyway, the boy is not so much into sports. He prefers gaming and Void Critters. He loves Void Critters and he loves gaming. And he's more of in a neutral relationship with his mom, which may change. We don't know how that will go when we play this, but we'll see. Anyway, he and the daughter are pretty close. They spend a lot of time together since the mom is usually working, so they are on their own a lot. They spend a lot of time with the uncle, which I forgot to mention, does not live with them. The uncle lives somewhere else together with the father of the mom, aka grandfather of the kids. The uncle and the grandfather are gonna be living together somewhere. I imagine that the uncle is taking care of the grandpa. And the grandpa isn't really liking the way mom goes about her life at this moment. He's like, you need to take some more time off, spend it with the family. Needless to say, he is a very family-oriented sim. He's like, you gotta stop working so much, you gotta spend time with the kids. She's like, no, I gotta work because I gotta provide for the kids. They need a good future. That's the dynamic between those two. Then there's also the cat. You can see him in the very bottom, his icon. You can see him in the end of the video, but his name is Sammy and he's the absolute cutest cat that exists. I may give the family a hamster too. I don't know yet. Thinking about it, I don't even know if I'm gonna do this let's play. So I have not decided on that yet. And then the very last sim that I haven't talked about, but that's not gonna be in this family, is the ex-husband of the mom. He is basically the evil ex of the story. Like, they didn't split up peacefully. He's a mean man. But he's still, you know, in the world. And yeah, I want to find out about the sentiments and how that works. So that's why I added this element to the gameplay. I wanted some negative sentiments towards certain sims, see how that works, you know? So that's why. And then that's it for this family. Like, I've already told about the other sims that I added in the save file. So yeah, that's the story. Please let me know if this sounds interesting to you, if you want to watch this let's play. There is something else, by the way, that I would like your guys' input on. I'm gonna ask this on social media as well. I am thinking of doing another tutorial, and I was wondering if there are any issues, things, topics, either in-game or that have to do with CC and mods, that you guys would like a tutorial for. Like, some ideas I have are finding broken CC or where to find good CC, those kind of things, maybe in-game issues as well. I don't really know what would be useful to make a tutorial about that's in-game. But you guys gotta let me know if there are any things you would like a tutorial about. And this is completely off-topic, but I have been watching this series called The Queen's Gambit with my boyfriend, and I am loving it so far. And I was wondering if any of you are watching it too, because I think it is very popular, but I personally don't know anyone who is also watching this series. I think it's so interesting and it just sucks me right into the story. I love it so much. And the weird thing is that the main character, I don't know the name of the actress, but she looks a lot like a friend of mine. Like, a lot. She has a very particular face, and I have never seen anyone else besides my friend with a face that looks like that. But then I saw this actress, I was like, whoa, they look alike. I also recently got a chessboard, not because of the series, but our neighbors were moving out and they had a chessboard that I didn't want anymore, so we took it. I used to know how to play chess when I was a kid. I played a few matches, that's literally all I did, but now I am kind of interested in picking that up again. I think my boyfriend knows how to play it, so he should be able to teach me. And I am excited to actually learn that. Thing is, I usually don't really like board games, like Monopoly. No, thank you. I don't really like it. And then, I don't know if it's called the same way in English, but Risk. That is my least favorite game ever. I really dislike playing that. I do like the Catan games. What are they called in English? I just think Catan, right? Anyway, that one. And when I was little, I used to like the Cluedo? I looked it up and apparently it's just called Clue, at least in North America. So that game where you like solve a mystery and stuff. I really liked that one too. And that's basically my knowledge of board games. There's also some card games that I like, but I don't know if they even exist outside of the Netherlands and what their names would be. But yeah, that's games I like. I am not that much into board games and stuff, but I would like to get more into it. I used to play checkers with my brother whenever we went on a vacation. We would play it in the car, like we had this special travel edition of checkers. But my brother, like, he couldn't stand losing, so it wasn't fun. So that was kind of a pity. I think I'm going to be ending this voiceover here. There are going to be some screenshots of all the Sims after the voiceover, so if you want to stay to check those out, feel free to do so. As I mentioned, I have been streaming on Twitch a lot lately, so if you want to see me play The Sims or any other games live on Twitch, go follow me there. It's just called Simming Bird, just like my YouTube. The link is also in the description. And also, let me know in the comments whether you are interested in the Snowy Escape Let's Play and what things you would like tutorials for, if there are any things you would like tutorials for. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it and subscribe if you haven't already. It really helps out the channel. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye!